When young Edward Morant arrived on our shore, Australia was not yet a nation. He was keen to discover what fate had in store, and he worked on a North Queensland station. A young Irish girl was the governess there, and her charms he was quick to admire. He wooed her and won her, their lives they would share, and he married sweet Daisy O'Dwyer. But the marriage was doomed, for Daisy soon learned that she had been hasty and rash. Forward Edwin borrowed, he never returned, and he wasn't too honest with cash. He saddled his horse and rode off down the track, for his marriage with Daisy was over. To his young Irish love he would never go back, and he followed the life of a drover. It was when he decided to alter his name, and he called himself Harry Morant. But this was the start of a confidence game, which he played when his money was scant. I'm the prodigal son of an old English knight, he said as his creditors sighed. My father, Sir Digby, will set your bill right, but Sir Digby, he never replied. So Daisy moved on, and the record relates her next marriage too was a failure. She lived with the tribes and was called Daisy Bates in the vastness of Western Australia. Now Harry was great at the rough riding game, the sort of bloke stockmen admire. It was skill with the horses that soon brought him fame, and his deeds were retold round the fire. In the calm of the night, on a far distant track, to the music of horse bells' soft chimes, he'd dash off some verses about the outback. He was handy with words and with rhymes. He signed himself Breaker because he broke horses, was published with banjo and Lawson. And out where the rivers run down their slow courses, was known as a poet and horseman. He wrote of the stars shining bright on a camp by the banks of the far castle rain. He wrote of the nights that were dewy and damp, and of girls he had met on the way. He remembered a horse that was willful and strong, but could wield a wild steer or cow. We've heard of that horse in the ballad and song, who's riding old Harlequin now. Then came the Boer War, and he answered the call. He was sent where the fighting was hot, with orders unclear, he saw his mates fall. and somehow some prisoners were shot. He was sentenced to death by a kangaroo court, together with Handcock, his mate. He said his last words as the game, as he fought, "Come on, you bastards, shoot straight." Because of injustice, his spirit won't rest, and he's back in Australia, of course. He's haunting the stock routes he followed out west, and he rides on the ghost of his horse. I reckon I'd seen them as morning mist lift from the banks of the Darling, I vow. Then into the cool of a silent they drift, and he's riding old Harlequin.